Hello all, we are going through the course Basic Electrical Engineering, which is offered by both Bikaner Technical University and Rajasthan Technical University for all the branches in BTEC first year. We are following unit number 1, which is DC circuits. We have already gone through electrical circuit elements like R, L and C. We have covered voltage and current sources. Now before going through KCL and KVL, Kirchhoff current and voltage laws, let's see Ohm's law first. Okay, so in this lecture we'll go through Ohm's law. Before going through Ohm's law, let's see some very fundamental but important concept. And this concept is, what do you understand by plus minus sign on any electrical circuit element? Like here we have a resistor, and across the resistor plus minus sign has been mentioned, and with this plus minus sign VR has been written. So what is the meaning of this plus minus? That we have to understand. Similarly, in this circuit the same thing has been written, plus minus sign across this voltage source, across this resistance also the same thing has been written. In this circuit three different things has been shown. One is the current, okay, another is the voltage VS with this plus minus sign. So typically, what is the meaning of this plus minus? Okay, so quickly I would like to mention, this plus minus is what? This is the way of measurement. Okay, and what is the arrow? Arrow, like here we have seen arrow, here also we have seen arrow, here also in this circuit arrow has been marked. So this arrow is the way of measurement of current. So from this time you have to keep in mind that this plus minus sign is the way of measurement of voltage. Okay, of voltage, whereas this arrow marking is the way of measurement of current. Okay, so these two things you have to remember. Now to measure this voltage, why we are putting plus and minus sign? What is the significance of it? Okay, so typically this minus represents reference of that particular measurement. So across this element voltage has been measured. It is measured at this point, and that's why plus sign we are getting at this place. And it is measured with respect to this node, and that's why there is a minus sign. Okay, so this minus sign is reference point for this voltage measurement. Okay, it doesn't represent high potential or low potential. Okay, this is wrong concept. Okay, this doesn't represent high or low potential. It is typically representing way of measurement, where plus sign is showing the place where we are measuring the voltage, and minus sign is showing the reference of that measurement. Okay, it will be more clear from this. Here we have a multimeter, and with the help of this multimeter we are measuring the voltage across this battery terminal. Okay, so we know that in multimeter we have red probe and black probe. Okay, so this black probe has been placed at this point, and red probe has been placed at this point. It means voltage of this terminal has been measured with respect to this, and it is E. Here it is, it has been shown. Okay, and this ammeter is connected in series, obviously. Okay, the place where we have connected its red probe, it means we are measuring the flow of current in this direction. Okay. Let's see another example. Here we have a DC voltage and there is a resistance. Okay. These two elements are connected in parallel, so easily we can say that the voltage across the resistance will be 6 volt in the magnitude. Voltage across resistance in magnitude, of, if I will say, it will be equal to 6 volt. But it depends on the way of measurement, whether my measurement will be plus 6 volt or minus 6 volt. Okay. For example, here potential of this terminal has been measured with respect to this. Why I have written plus here? Because this red probe is here and black probe is here, and that's why negative sign will be at this place and positive sign will be this place. Okay. If I'm measuring the potential in this way, so what I'm going to get? I'm going to get plus 6 volt. Same voltage, same circuit, there is no change in circuit. Now way of measurement has been changed. Now I'm measuring the potential of this node B with respect to A, and that's why minus sign is towards A and plus sign is towards B, and at this time the measurement will be minus 6 volt. Okay, so I hope it is clear that this minus represents reference point and this plus is the node where we are measuring the voltage. Now let's go through Ohm's law. So Ohm's determined experimentally that current in a resistive circuit is directly proportional to its applied voltage and inversely proportional to its resistance under constant environmental condition. This is very important. Okay. In another way, we can say that the ratio of potential difference V between any two points on a conductor to the current I following between them is constant provided the temperature of the conductor doesn't change. In a very simple language, I will say that the voltage across an element, resistive element, is directly proportional to current following through it, obviously under constant environmental condition. Mathematically, it is given by V directly proportional to I, and if I will remove this proportionality sign, then we'll have equal to, and there will be a constant. Here constant is resistance of that element, so V equal to IR is a mathematical equation. Now we, in some of the standard book, you'll see that at the voltage is represented by either V or E, so you do not have to confuse about this sign capital E. Okay, like here E has been written at the place of V, so it depends on the book or people that any symbol can be used. Okay. So this experiment which Ohm's conducted can be understood by this circuit and this graph here. The value of this resistance is 10 ohm. If I will keep this value of resistance 10 ohm, and if I am changing this DC voltage E from 0 to 50 as it has been done over here, so I can easily find out the current quantity, and after plotting the graph, we can see the relationship between voltage and current, and it can be proved through this mathematical equation. Okay, like if voltage is 0, E equal to 0, R equal to 10, so current is going to be 0, so current is here. If voltage is 10, okay, voltage is 10 and resistance is 10, so current will be 1 ampere, so second coordinate we are getting at this place. Similarly, when voltage is 20 volt, current will be 2 ampere, so third coordinate. After matching all the points, we are getting a straight line, which is proving this Ohm's law. So from this experiment, Ohm's found that voltage is directly proportional, but under environmental condition, because you know that resistance changes by the change in environmental condition, particularly change in temperature. Now let's find out what would be the value of R in this given circuit. Okay, so applied voltage is 6 volt. Current which is passing through this resistance is 25 milliampere. So by using Ohm's law, easily I can find out V equal to IR, and so R will be equal to V upon I. The value of V equal to 6. V or E both are the same thing, and current is 25 milliampere. So it is going to be 6 upon 25 kilo ohm. Okay. Okay. If I will simplify this in a further step, so at the place of kilo, I can write 1000, and this is divided by 25. So this is going to be equal to 40, and final answer will be 240 ohm. So either I can write 6 upon 25 kilo ohm, or we can go for one more step, and we can find out the value equal to 240 ohms, which has been given over here. Now, let's see what would be the polarity of voltage with respect to direction of current. Okay, so you have to remember two things. First one, if current is entering through positive sign of voltage measurement, then measured voltage will be positive. And if current is entering through negative sign of the measurement, then measured voltage will be negative. Let's see the same thing with an example. Here this current is entering through this resistance, and the voltage has been measured in this manner. Here we have plus sign of the measurement and minus sign of the measurement is here. That means this is the reference point of the measurement, and this is the node where we are measuring the voltage. This is the measuring point, and this is the reference point. Okay, in this, current is coming from top to bottom. Okay, since current is coming from top to bottom, so what is the sign which has been seen by this current? I, it is a positive sign, and that's why the measured voltage will be positive. Okay, you can see this example also. Suppose someone is saying find out the value of this voltage V through the Ohm's law. I know that magnitude will be equal to I into R. Okay, whether it will be positive voltage or negative, it depends on how current is entering. If current is entering, and firstly it is entering through this positive sign, so this voltage will be positive. Like here, current is entering through negative sign, so this voltage will be equal to, magnitude will remain same. There is no change in magnitude. But since this current is entering from this side now, so firstly it encounters with negative sign, and that's why the voltage will be negative. So these two statements you have to remember. Whenever you are writing Ohm's law, magnitude will be IR, whether voltage will be positive or negative, it depends how current is entering through that particular resistor. If it is entering to the measurement positive terminal, it means the voltage will be positive. If current is entering through the negative of the measurement, negative sign of the measurement, it means that voltage will be negative. Okay, like here we have 5 ohm resistance, and this 5 ampere current is entering through positive of this positive sign of the measurement terminal, and that's why the voltage will be plus 25 volt. Now find out, these are the questions. We have to find out what will be shown in this multimeter. Okay, so here how voltage is measured? Voltage is measured in this manner. Why I'm writing plus? Red probe and black probe, and that's why I'm writing plus and minus sign over here. Whatever current is entering, that's magnitude is 3 ampere, it is entering through positive signs of this measurement. So the measured voltage will be positive, and what will be the magnitude? So plus sign I have to give because it is entering to the plus, and resistance value equal to 10 and current value equal to 3. So magnitude will be 3 multiplied with 10. So this is going to be equal to 30 volt. So this multimeter will show 30 volt, plus 30 volt, I will say. Okay. Now see the second case. Let me delete. This area. Okay. So here measurement way is this one. In this way voltage has been measured. Okay. What will be the magnitude of the voltage? 2 ampere current is passing and the value of resistance is 36 ohm. So this is 36. Okay. And this current is entering through the negative sign of this voltage measurement. So we have to put negative sign over here. So this is going to be equal to minus 72 volt. So this multimeter will show the voltage minus 72. Now again I have to erase this one. Okay. Now see the third case. In this case, voltage has been measured in this manner. As per the probe, I'm writing the way of measurement. Okay. And this is the voltage which has been measured. This is the V3 I am writing. So how much will be V3? By Ohm's law, magnitude will be IR. I equal to R, what? 6, and R equal to 15. Okay. And this current is entering through this reference sign of the measurement, and that's why this voltage will be negative. So this is going to be equal to minus 90 volt. So here minus 90 volt will be shown. Now let's see the fourth case. Again, I have to delete this area to understand the question clearly. Okay. Here, way of measurement is what? It is in this manner. Current is entering through positive terminal. Let's say this is the voltage V4. So magnitude of V4 will be equal to I 4 ampere, resistance 40 ohm. Okay, so 4 multiplied with 40. And since this current is entering through this positive sign, so we have to put positive sign at this place, and this is going to be equal to 160 volt. Okay, so this is plus 160 volt, which has been shown by this multimeter. So I hope this concept is clear to all of you. Okay, so we'll stop over here. In the next class, we shall go through KVL, Kirchhoff voltage law. Thank you.